Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to take this green sea moss and make it into sea moss gel. First, we're going to take the sea moss and put it into a strainer and rinse it until we can get as much of the salt and dirt and debris off of it as possible. Once we have washed it thoroughly, we will then set it to soak. So we're going to strain all that water off, and then we're going to put it in a bowl so that we can cover it with water. We will cover the sea moss with water and try and get that water over the sea moss about 2 inches, because the sea moss is going to absorb the water that you put in the bowl, and it's going to expand 3 times its size. What I am using now is a full package of my sea moss. So as you can see, the sea moss is fully covered, and now it is soaking in a bowl of water, and I will soak it for at least 4 hours, but I like to do it overnight. You can do it up to 24 hours, no problem. The sea moss has soaked for about 12 hours. Look at it now. Look how much it has expanded. This will make a lot of sea moss gel. Now I'm going to strain and rinse the sea moss yet again before I prepare it into gel form. And I'm just gonna rinse it thoroughly until it feels like it's nice and clean, and then I'm gonna add it to my blender and then add the water to the blender. So the amount of water is going to be different for everybody. I believe that I like it right around 8 cups of water for a full package of my sea moss, but you can actually add more or less. It depends on the consistency in which you like your sea moss. And the thing about sea moss is that when you put it in a refrigerator after it's done, it's actually going to get thicker. This is what it looks like once it has been blended in my blender. And so now I am adding some lime juice, and I'm gonna blend that in just slightly, just so that it's mixed in, and that helps preserve the sea moss, and it also gives it a nicer flavor. So there you have it, sea moss gel. This made 6 16-ounce jars of sea moss gel.